Hello, it's Ash, and today I'm going to continue cleaning the Vachetta leather on my pre-owned and vintage Louis Vuitton Neverfull PM. Again, one strap on this bag has already been deep cleaned, so we're going to work on the other strap today. I also just wanted to quickly share the final results with you guys, just so that you guys can see how beautiful the straps do look now. Again, the products I'm using today are just distilled water, the Lexol all leather cleaner step one, a few microfiber towels, and one soft brush. So just like before, I pour distilled water into a bowl to make my microfiber towel damp. Then I put some of that leather cleaner into a smaller container so that I can easily get more product as I need it. I'm also using a soft makeup brush to really lather the product and then brush it onto the leather. I'll then finally wipe all of that stuff off later on with the microfiber towel. But you guys have seen me do this before, so I'm not going to really commentate as much today. I'm just going to kind of fast forward this so that you guys can see this whole entire process of me cleaning this one strap. Alright, so now that I'm done, I'm gonna let it air dry in my studio. You can see the water is evaporating, but it does take a little bit more time than the handles, so I did have to wait about 5 hours for more accurate results. And here it is. The handles look thoroughly cleaned. There is no more dirt or oil. The patina does still look a little bit darker near the handles, but it is not as bad as what it looked like before. And the underside of it also just looks so amazing. Alright, so now I'm going to go ahead and remove all of this tape and the towels so that we can look at both of the straps and compare them. So here is the moment of truth. Do they look the same? Yes, they do. I think one side is a little bit darker than the other side, but you guys, they look so good together, and I just cannot believe it. It was just dirt and oil that was making the handles look really, really dark. But what I'm also realizing now is that there is a lot of wear and tear on the leather handles. It doesn't look as smooth anymore. These parts actually look kind of fuzzy, and it does kind of worry me about the leather fibers becoming loose, especially around the edges where the dye is. So I'm going to have to polish this leather later. I'll probably try to burnish it with some water first. Worst case scenario, I can always use some toconol to seal everything in. But yeah, all that dirt and oil from the previous owner kind of sealed all of this stuff in, but we don't want to continue doing that. So it's a good thing that I was able to remove all of that and fix this leather going forward. Alright, so here are the final results, and I want to share with you guys what it looked like before and after I cleaned it. Again, we worked on the strap that's on the right side, and just look at it, you guys. It's like night and day. It's so shocking, and I'm just super happy that I was able to remove a majority of that dirt and grime off of the handles, because that's what really made the handles look really dark. And again, here's a look at the chaps. They look, there's no difference in them, but the straps had the biggest difference, I feel like, and that's probably what deterred a lot of people from picking up this bag. But yeah, everything else on this bag just looks amazing, and I love it, you guys. There are a few more steps actually taking care of this leather, which is conditioning the leather after you clean it, because what usually happens is when you clean the leather, all of the water evaporates, but at the same time, it takes out all of the oils that was in the leather. So you have to go back and condition it to put that oil back into the leather so that it remains supple throughout the years. Again, I will share how I condition this leather, and I'll also share all the products that I use. I've done this before on my Delightful PM, so I'm going to do it again for this bag. But again, I am just so surprised and so happy with the results. And again, it just makes me feel so happy that I purchased this bag for such a great price. I knew it was just dirty and that I could fix it. It makes me also actually wonder if I could do this for other bags, like the Speedy bags, because they have those top handles which are really, really dirty sometimes, and I feel like this solution might work even better for that product, but that'll have to be for like another video one day. So we're going to go ahead and end it here today. I will be cleaning the rest of this bag in a couple of days. I'll share with you guys how I cleaned the trim and also the side drawstrings. I'll also be cleaning the inside because the bag does have a little bit of leather inside of there. So I'll have that video coming up soon too. This video is really long already, so we're going to cut it short today and stop here. Thanks again for watching, you guys. My name is Ash, and I'll see you guys next time.